Anna, grazie per condividere la live. Bacio. Lavora in un ufficio importante. Mia padre. Ok, now I see Red Raw, thanks for sharing the live. I see different answers finally. So we have Carolina, il mio padre, Emilia, mio padre, Lena, il mio padre. Then I see mio padre, mio padre, mio padre, il mio padre, il mio padre. Ma figurati, David. Victorella, hi, il mio padre. Ciao, Victorella. Allora. Think about it. The sentence means works in an important office. Works in an important office. How would you say it in English? In English, you would say my dad works in an important office. You would not put the article in English. This is why in Italian it's not il, it's my dad. Brava Nede. You don't need il. Exactly. Mia. This is wrong because Mia is feminine. Mia is feminine and padre is masculine. Just mio padre. Yes. Next. Io. Italiano da 3 anni. Studia, studio, studiam. What is studiam? My God. This test is too easy, guys. Everyone killing it with studio. Bravi. Bravi tutti. Studio, esatto. Io studio da 3 anni. Troppo facile. Bravissimi, proud of you guys. Tariq, grazie per la rosa. Bacio. Ups. Easy. Next. I miei amici tutte le sere uscono, escono, escono. Which one? I miei amici tutte le sere. My friends every evening escono. Escono. Ok. Let me bring this life to the next level. Actually, nah. I wanted to show you the conjugation of uscire, go out, but it's correct. Escono means uscire, which is, sorry, escono is the conjugated form of uscire, which means to go out or exit, to exit. Erika, grazie delle rose. The right, oops, what is this? The right one is escono, because, okay, let me bring it to the next level. I'm showing with you my board. It's loading. I'm gonna call it. So this is my board, a new board. I'm gonna call it Italian Classes. Tony, just give me a second. Italian Live. TikTok Live. And I'm gonna show you the conjugate. What? Ah! It's updating. Okay, while it's updating, we do the next. Escono is they go out. It's go out, yeah. It's they go out, but third person plural, they go out. Next. Cinzia. Una lettera ai suoi genitori ogni settimana. Cinzia something a letter to her parents every week. Ciao Steven, buonasera. Scriva, scrive, scrivi. Let's see. Scrive. Scriva, scriva, scrive. Definitely scrive. Scriva. Ok. The correct one is scrive, but TikTok board. So, there it is. I'm gonna write in a blank page. Here for you, the conjugation of some verbs. How do I make it so that you see? So here, and now I have to zoom in. Let me zoom in, and now I move here. And we're gonna write the conjugation of uscire, to go out. Uscire, to go out, because there was some confusion earlier. And we're gonna write it here for everyone to take a screenshot with my face on it. No, too big. So, ready everyone? Let's go. First we do all the subjects. Io tu, lui, lei, noi, voi, loro. So this is irregular. Brava Nede. Io esco, tu esci, it's irregular. Lui, lei esce, noi usciamo, voi uscite, loro escono. This is uscire, to go out. Take a screenshot if you need. To go out or exit. Or exit. So, said that, let's go back to our test. Scrive is correct. Cinzia scrive una lettera ai suoi genitori. Let me move this a bit more like this. Okay, answer question. Next, cameriere, vorrei un piatto spaghetti per favore. This is condizionale. Vorrei is condizionale. And it means cameriere, waiter. Cameriere is waiter. I would like a dish. Spaghetti, please. Di di di. Everyone says di. Dove, 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 ombra. Yes. Bravi tutti. Di. Waiter, I would like a dish of spaghetti, please. Con means with. And al means to the. This is off, so correct. Next, noi abitiamo vicino stazione. So, we live close train station. We live close train station. Della alla di. I see Erika Della. Tari, grazie per la rosa. Alla. Most of the people are saying alla. And in English it would be we live close to the station. Della perché è plurale. Steven, it's to the. Della either means of the or yeah. Della actually means of the. And in some cases also means some. But in this case we want to say to the. Alla is to the. And because I'm a nerd, I'm gonna show you. Oh, my keyboard is full of yogurt. So we wanna say tip. I'm gonna call it tip for you guys. And this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna take two, and then we're gonna take il, lo, la, I, li, and le. I don't know if it fits the screen, it probably doesn't, but then I'm gonna delete this. And tu, or in Italian a, actually. And what this becomes, when you sum them together, become al, my god. If you sum them together, become al, allo, alla, and all of this means to the, ai, and then agli, and then alle. All of this means to the. And you take a and you sum all the articles. That all means to the. Easy. And the same is if you do di, If you do D and you change, it's del, dello, della, degli, delle, delle, and so on. So, back to us. Allah is correct. Well done, everyone. You're streaming on weekend, Elif. Actually, I stream only when I don't have classes. I have private classes almost all the time, so I don't have much time to stream. But usually I keep the evenings of my weekends free, because usually I go out, I meet friends, I do things. But today the weather in Berlin is horrible, so I am streaming. Correct. Parlare italiano, poi conosci sai. Which one is it? Poi conosci sai. Any guess? Anyone? Poi sai, sai, conosci. Poi. Okay, so I have to say that two answers are possible in the sense that they are grammatically acceptable, both of them, but I think that only one is logically correct. So, this means speak Italian. The first one would be, can you speak Italian? This one is completely wrong. Conoscere means to know, but a person. Conoscere is to know a person. And sai is also to know, but sai comes from sapere. It is also to know, but to know, to possess knowledge, you know, to know something. This is mainly to know someone. This is to know something. So, back to us. Can you speak Italian? That is grammatically correct. This one is not correct because it refers to a person. The last one is, do you know how to speak Italian? Now, in English, it's fine if you say, can you speak Italian? But in Italian, you cannot really say, puoi, I mean, you can say, puoi parlare italiano, but it's very weird. The more correct one logically is sai. It's like, do you possess the knowledge of speaking Italian? Sai parlare italiano? But if you say puoi, everyone understands. It's not so wrong. I will put sai, but this is because we want to be very nerd and particular. Samina, thanks for sharing the live. Emilia, thanks for sharing the live. Bacio. Next. L'anno scorso a Roma. Ciao Rika, come stai? L'anno scorso a Roma. Which one? This is passato prossimo, it's not an easy one. Ciao Capu, buonasera. Tutto bene? Siamo andati. Abbiamo andati. Allora, the rule is that if you have a movement verb, so last year, the sentence is, last year we went to Rome. Last year we went to Rome. Now, to go, andare, is a verb of movement. You know, to go, andare, movement. And in Italian, all the verb of movements use essere. So, you have to use essere. Then, because it says siamo, it means we, plural. You have to use andati with I at the end because it's plural. This one is singular. It would be io sono andato, tu sei andato, but noi, We siamo andati. So, siamo andati is actually correct. Andare, a verb of movement, so you use essere as a auxiliary verb and then the I at the end because it's plural. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy, we go next. Bravi tutti. Ieri sera a Sandra, ma non era in casa. Yesterday evening to Sandra, but she was not home. Let's see what you guys are saying. Ho telefonato. Easy this one. Everyone is saying ho telefonato. First. Yeah, this, I have to say that this website is very easy. Ho telefonato is correct. Because to call is not a verb of movement, so you don't use essere. Telefonata is completely wrong. And I have called, I have phoned. So that's correct, easy. Next, quando a Roma abbiamo visitato San Pietro. When in Rome we visited San Pietro. Which one is this? Joe, you can type. No guesses. Nede, eravamo. This is imperfetto. Eravamo. Ti ricordi quando io e te eravamo, re? Eravamo. Karen says avevamo. So, this is not an Italian word. It does not exist, the first one. Evavamo, it's not Italian. It's made up language. Then it's... Avevamo means we had. Where. So the correct one is we were, because when we were in Rome, we visited San Pietro. This tense is called imperfetto. Imperfetto del verbo essere. And it's a past tense. Next. This is future. Next year, l'anno prossimo, io e Mario. Prossimo means next. Next year. Ci sposeremo, Tiana. Ci sposeremo, Nede. Red, Rod, ci sposeremo. Seconds for Steven. Sposaremo. Sposaremo or sposeremo? Ci sposeremo. So, two things to keep in mind. Sposarsi is a reflexive verb. Sposarsi, because at the end is si. Sposarsi. This is tricky, yes. And when you conjugate a reflexive verb, you have to conjugate the particle, sposarsi. In this case, it's io e Mario, so we. Plural, we, you will have to use ci. Now, the verb is sposarsi, but the conjugation is noi ci sposeremo, not sposaremo. The future form, the future of sposarsi, ends with eremo. Actually, it would be the future of sposare. Are, regular verb ending in are, at the future form, the we, noi, is eremo. So, L'anno prossimo io e Mario ci sposeremo. It was tricky. Well done to everyone who did it correctly. Next. Quel ragazzo non voglio vedere mai più. Now, the level is going up. Zilani, thanks for follow. The level is going up. Flower Life, grazie per il love me. Grazie per il cuore. So, this one is tricky. Quel means that. That boy don't want see him ever again. So everyone is saying lo, 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 gli, lo. Steven, why you said? Are you sad or are you thinking? What is this emote? I cannot get it from the PC. No, this is... So, the correct one is lo, because it's direct object. I don't want to see him anymore. Quel ragazzo non lo voglio vedere mai più. This is correct. Ci usually refers to us. There are some exceptions. Gli means to him. Most of the time, gli as a pronoun means to him. In this case, you don't want to say to him. You want the direct object. Him. Lo. Next. Ho telefonato a Simona e... Simona and I told her all the truth. La, le, gli. This one is super tricky. I have something in my eye. So I have seen le, gli, la, le, la, le. Le. Which one is it gonna be? Gli, this is a guess. It's okay. We are here to guess, and then I will give you the right answer. Le, this is a hard one. So, on the contrary of the previous one, here we have an indirect object. Indirect object. It's not direct, it's indirect. Because you would say, actually, yeah, in Italian you would say, like in English, it's like you would say I told the truth to her. So the truth is the direct object, and her, which would be to her, is the indirect object. And the equivalent form of to her in Italian is le. La is a direct object, and it's the equivalent of lo at the masculine. La is feminine. Gli is the masculine equivalent of le. So both le and gli are indirect objects, but le is to her, gli is to him. Pay attention that many, many, many Italians, almost all the Italians, in this sentence, they would say gli, because it's very common in the Italian language to use the masculine. So, even if it were a direct object, the past participle would be feminine, so you can infer it's indirect. That's correct, Joe. Non capisco bene l'inglese, ma capisco bene l'italiano. Allora, lo spiego, I'm gonna explain it one more time in Italian. So, Steven, le... Allora, in questa frase dobbiamo usare il pronome personale indiretto. La è un pronome personale diretto, femminile. A noi serve il pronome personale indiretto. Le egli sono due pronomi personali indiretti. Le vuol dire a lei, gli vuol dire a lui. Simona è una donna, quindi dobbiamo dire le, perché è una donna, le vuol dire a lei, ci riferiamo a a una persona di sesso femminile. Gli vuol dire a lui. Useremmo gli nel caso stessimo facendo riferimento a un uomo. Quindi le is correct. Well done everyone. Bravi tutti. From now on, every time I explain a rule, I will explain it in English. So Nede is saying, what if we write l'ho detto? That's also not correct, because the ho starts with, no, it's not, because ho starts with the consonant. Or let me think. No, here, so you can say l'ho detto, you can say l'ho detto, but not in this case. Because the L apostrophe means it. In this case, the L apostrophe means it. Monse, grazie. Un bacio. Very sweet of you, Monse. My mother language, Spanish, so I don't find it so difficult. Only for the art objects. Yes, exactly, Joe. Exactly. L apostrophe means it, so it's a direct object. Ho telefonato a Simona e le ho detto tutta la verità. Next. So, as I said, I'm gonna explain the rule first in English and then I'm gonna explain it in Italian. When I speak Italian, I will speak slowly, so you will get it. Next. Non posso più di tutto questo rumore. This